Everyone! How you doing today? Cosmic, Goose, Illich, Samia, Pipe-san. Rohel, Joel-san, Hongmao, Kenneth, and Red. And Nashu. So... I have learned a lot of things since last week, and I would like to share with you guys. Oh yes, you guys can see. I have created some absolute units. Here I am, and here's you guys. I think I like the small version better. I've been practicing pixel art for the game I want to create, for those who don't know. And I'm referencing, of course, Harvest Moon Mineral Town, and also Zelda the Minish Cap. The artwork is so beautiful. Never heard of it before until now. So I made a set of tiles like this. They piece together, and some bushes, essential for farming sims, and of course bread. This is going to be a definitive feature of our game here. Thank you. Hello, are you's in chat, guys. Joel-san. I love your work. I love your songs. I'm just joking. Hilly, farm game mock-up. Yeah, well, I wouldn't exactly call this a mock-up, because this is completely not what it's going to look like. I'm just trying to grasp the basics of pixel art. I can see it and feel it in your soul. Gameplay green screenshots, not really. Just trying things out is not going to look like this. It's going to look even better, okay? I'll zoom out for you guys. It's very bare bones. Here I am, collecting Moltex. Thank you, Nashu. Minish Kappa GBA Classic. I never played it, now I wish I did. The bushes do look Zelda-ish. I really like the hue shift to blue on the shadows. And I have your bread. I guess geese do like bread, don't they? The other day I saw a family bring Cheerios to the lake and feed ducks with Cheerios. Do you prefer Cheerios or bread? Cause I'd like to keep my bread. Yes, tuna is me. Most for friendship and me. Hello, Folly! No worries, not late. Just getting started. We have so much to talk about. So, I guess, table of contents. I had some big questions, like, when I was trying to get started last week. So, biggest questions were, which engine do I choose? Did I write it? Which engine do I choose? Where do I start? And then I found out that people hate farming sims now. Did you guys know? We'll get into it. And another more technical question I had was, what resolution do I draw in? And Some people make fun of people for asking about resolution, but I feel like it's a very, very valid question because before you pour your heart and soul into peace, you want to make sure you're not going to run into issues after you finish it, right? So we'll get into that. And I also have a bunch of concept sketches to show you guys. Here they are. Have a bunch, and maybe I can write out the big questions. Which engine? I am actually not entirely sure, but I think I am going to go for Godot because I like the interface. And that's it. I feel like in terms of programming, I'm not doing anything too crazy, so I feel like most programs can handle what I'm trying to make. Probably Godot. And it's open source, which means I think people can share resources in the community and you can plug it into your game. And that saves you a bit of time. I think that's what it means, but I need to do more research. But I think interface is really important. Because if an interface is bad, then you waste a lot of time trying to look for stuff and figuring out how it works. But my concern is that the coding language is Godot's own coding language and is similar to Python. But I have heard that people recommend C#, or is it C++, for gaming. So I don't know if I'll run into issues. I'll decide next week. I feel like I'll be okay with Python. Nothing too crazy. Godot, you like Godot, okay. who says no farming sim? I'm just saying people hate it. And this is a problem that can be solved, right? It's a challenge. And then next is related to this. Next big question is, where do I start? Like, do I just try to learn code in the beginning, especially as a 2D artist? Where is a good place to start? And I was watching Adam's video, who's a pixel art artist and game dev. He made a really good point, and I'm saying that if you're better at the visual stuff, more familiar with the visual stuff, make a full mock-up that shows the final vision. Which this is not. This is not my final vision, just so you know, but that's what I'm gonna do next. With pixel art. And that really made me feel less lost, you know? Like, this is doable. I can do a mock-up. So I recommend that for my fellow artists. Next thing is... the fact that people hate farming sim. Farming sims. I don't know how to keep this visually interesting. Whatever. I'm just gonna do whatever. Mock up. And then farming sim hate. And this is where I, because when I do a big project, I like to look at videos and other people's perspectives. I'm basically looking for people who are trying to convince, to try and convince myself to not do this thing. Like, I wanted to be VTuber, so I would watch videos of people telling you why you shouldn't be a VTuber. And then I would be like, do I still really want to do it even after hearing that? And do I have a way to resolve these issues? And I guess we can get into it later. And my solution is to add an element. And make it the main focus. An element that I have not seen in a lot of recent games, but it has been done really well in the past, and I will show you the exact mini game I'm talking about in a second. And actually, I can show you now. We can skip to this, which is, I'm going to add baking as a main element in my game. And it's going to, the interface is going to look like this. And you can mix the ingredients. There'll be a bowl, and then you have a whisk or something like this. Then you mix the ingredients, and then at the end you can customize your own bread and sell it on your shelf. Was inspired by the Buff Bear breads. And it's actually, I feel like it won't be too difficult to make, because it's just going to be a bunch of like the dough in simple shapes that you can arrange, maybe on a grid or even free not grid off the grid bread. You know, that would be super fun. And technically, you could make some very cursed or rude looking things, and that's the player has freedom to do that. I think that'll add a creative element to the game and keep people talking about it. Here's the inspo. So you just arrange the blobs, and then you save the design, and then you can have it on the shelf in your own bakery. And I'll show you this game I was inspired by. This is a Japanese, kind of like a browser cooking game. Cute idea, thank you. Ooh, hello Crunch Deluxe. First time seeing you. Godot supports C sharp. Yes, it does, but because I think most people use the Godot language, so there's not as many resources. Not as many resources on how to use C sharp on Godot. That's what I heard. Python good? Yeah. GD script is easy and fun. Cool. It's my first anyway. It does have a C-sharp option, probably not necessary here. Unless speed is a top priority. No, we're going... Actually, the opposite is true. It's a slow chill game. Hello, RM. It also supports visual scripting and C-sharp. The GD script is easier and good enough. Yeah, should be good enough. Where did you hear that? Somewhere. Through the grapevine. Oh, ohayou gozaimasu, Klo-san. Ima, gameu no hanashi wo shiteimasu. Watashi, gameu wo tsukuritai. Let's play a game. Let's play the flash game. Give me a moment to pull up. Wait, why is it crashed now? Oh my god, oh my god. Volume controls. Oh, cool. It's up. Let me select the screen, the window to capture. Do I see that? Ooh. Trying to crop out the unnecessary stuff. Where is it? You don't need to see that. You'll need to see sponsored links. Let's play it. It's so fun. I'll give you guys a link. There's BGM too, so let's pause this. Play, play, play. Volume control. Okay. Sound okay? Heaven Do Rising Physics. Yeah, how do you apply physics? Okay, so it's like this. Tamago wo kimasete keiki no kiji wo tsukutte ne. We have to whisk up the mixture within time limit. You have to get a certain number of rounds in, and then it determines how good quality the results will be. And here you have to wait until it looks like the sample. Try to get it as close as possible. If you wait too long, then the cake kind of collapses and it burns. We'll go for the good end first, and then I'll show you when you do it badly. And then you get to decorate it. And I think it will be so fun to have a bunch of toppings you can unlock. Through farming. Oh my god. Please. Let me cook. That's really annoying. And I think for... Hey! She's dissing my techniques. We like big cream. Okay, and then you put the strawberries on. I think for my game, it would be really nice to let the player design freely. And not have them judge your design. Yeah, it's kind of like Cooking Mama, but I like this more than Cooking Mama. Shibai! She's saying I failed! I can't believe this. This is the good end. Keiki oishiso. Shoto keiki. This is a good end. So, I think he probably said it looks a bit... it looks a bit questionable, but it tastes good. Let's do it poorly. No, I don't want to gambatte today. I want to bonk them on the head. I'm just gonna... I like this texture. This looks like it's... It would be not too difficult to make too. She said big fail. Let's burn the cake. You played this as a kid, Panakenneth? I love this so much. Do the Josh touches and whistle. I can't do. I don't know how to whistle. Also, my mic is going to cancel out the sound. Okay, so we've burned the cake. And then we're going to draw something incredibly inappropriate for our piece of shit boyfriend. Wow. So this is, you can also play like this, chaotically. I think that would be really funny. What do you guys think? What do you mean that I should buy? The best... This would so sell. Can you imagine custom orders with, you know, their name? Strawberry head, oh, too bad. Missed opportunity. And we've killed him. So yes. One of my favorite childhood browser games. I want to bring it to the modern world. Bring it to this era. This new age. It's a happy elephant, yeah. I like the sound design of that browser game too. When you mix the thing in, it goes chup 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 chup. I think ASMR can be an element. Beautiful. I killed him. It's a dark game. So where was I? Golems. Okay, so let's get through baking first. And I think... Wait, why is BGM? Keep going. I think it would be really cute to have. Do you guys know about sourdough starters? It's like a yeast culture that feels kind of like a pet. For bread makers who are into making sourdough, you will know. So it's this yeast culture that's made of water, flour, I think, and then and then it develops over time, but you have to feed it regularly, otherwise they become sad. I don't know what happens to them, honestly. I think, yeah, because they're so cute. The concept of feeding your sourdough starter is so cute. I think it'll be really fun to Tamagotchify it. And if you feed it good quality flour, then it becomes great quality, and then it makes your bread good quality. And how do you make good quality flour? You have to farm. And I guess now might be a good time to talk about why farming sims suck. Okay? Let's make a little... Let's make a little area for me to write on. Right here. Why? Farming sims suck. Let me know what you think of farming sims too. If you have opinions, you also think they suck for whatever reason, let me know. So biggest reason is farming is not rewarding. So backstory is that after the success of Stardew Valley, everyone and their mom started making farming sims, and the market is very saturated. And as of now, I think a few farming sims are scheduled to be released. But you can tell it's simply a cash grab. Because in the game, there's no point in farming. Because it's just not... It does not reward you. Like when you sell the vegetable, it does not sell for a lot. Probably you would get more by selling fish or ores, which is also a problem in Stardew Valley, which I want to fix. I don't like mining. No soul. And I feel like they're not adding anything to farming, like not going into more details and, you know, showing people why farming is fun. And mining too goated. Mining and fishing. He's a fish. he's a Mayray. She's too goated. Like, actually as well. She's like exploding still. Very happy for her. So how do we fix this? I have to give the players a reason to farm. So, and I made it make sense in the lore. So, Jamington is a cat. A cat town, right? And cats, they don't like to farm. They like to hunt or fish. Cats love violence. Fish. fish dead. So, and oh, thank you, Panda Kenneth, for joining members. Did you just join, or were you well, or was it like the members chat, or you just rejoined? Thank you, thank you. Okay, well, thank you for joining the garden again. Yeah, it really helps to just join members for $1. What was I saying? Okay, so the human and because the fish, no, the cats, they only like to fish and hunt. That means there's a lack of vegetables. No vegetables in this town. No vegetables. So human, you, the player, comes along and saves the day. I can hold a hoe. Right. And you will save all the humans from malnutrition. Sounds like a balancing issue. Exactly, we're going to balance it right now, as we speak. Which means vegetables sell for more money than fish and ores. This is where the moles come into play, okay? The friggin' ores, the gold ores that sell for $1 million. Well, not in this game because we are taking mole tax. We are charging mole tax. Because me, Tabby, dug this mine, so I charge you if you want to dig. Problem solved. Me holding the tax. Oh, thank you, Shiro, for joining the garden again. Yay, 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 yay. Pog, 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 pog. Oh, how long have you been here for? Certified Kusama. Oh, no. For fuck's sake. I'm so sad. Well, it became a podcast for a moment. Oh my god. You're gonna buy the... I'm dead. How to unfuck farming sim. Actually, that's a good one. Hello, El Tunis. Tuna has a rival. Oh my god, Tegu, hello. Well, I'm glad you went there to see me embarrass myself. I can't believe it. Ugh. I feel the urge to resign. Just joking. Anyways. Mole tax. Okay, mole tax. It was all very interesting. Cavs, don't worry. Thank you for laughing at me. Thank you. You are allowed to type in all caps if there is pawn happening. Okay, I permit. You have all caps perms. Okay, game balance. Yes, game balance. Fishing, debuff. Vegetable, big buff. So are the other animals for milk or something? Yes, yes, yes. You can get cows for milk to make milk bread. You know, all the regular farming sim elements will probably be present, but it all goes towards your bread game. So you feel like you have incentive to farm to unlock different toppings rather than you just ship off the vegetables for not very much money. No? Makes farming more exciting because you can make dumb bread. Okay, next one is how do we fix the mining situation? How do we make mining more fun? So I think the biggest feature will be golems that you can farm on. Holy shit! Just like Dungeon Meshi. I freaking love it. What bread for though? So you'll get a little bakery shop and then customers will come in and buy. And then maybe at the end of the week you'll see how many breads you sold. And how and the popularity of your bakery will be based on the quality of the ingredients that you get from farming. Yeah, keep the questions coming. So I'm thinking there'll be a set amount of levels in the mine, and each level will be like a puzzle, and one golem or two, I don't know, one golem will be trapped on the level, and as you mine and break the stones, you get to free him and take him to your dungeon farm where you keep the little golems, and then you can plant maybe magical, I don't know, magical vegetables, magical tomatoes with mana. I don't know yet. Either that or it can act as a greenhouse during winter. So you can still farm during winter. When everything is covered in snow, you can just go underground to your mine and, you know, farm on your little golems. I was thinking because it's very difficult to come up with a design that's better than this. You know, this design I have is still very similar. So to add a little bit of originality to it, maybe we can have different golems that are shaped differently. Maybe one looks more like four-legged animal. You know, we can have a stream where we come up with a bunch of design someday. Maybe we can have one that's like, I don't know, a pig form. You know? Like a little piglet. What else would be cool? Can we feed golems bread for bonuses? Yeah, that's why I added a mouth. You can feed it. I don't know what. I was thinking fertilizer, but maybe it will be fun for you to be able to feed anything to it. We can decide later. But yes, feedable. No. Let's give it a mouth. And I think my problem is I have lots of ideas, but implementing them is gonna be a problem. I never lack in ideas. What would be other fun shapes? Oh my god, Isa and the sea doggos have joined. Hello, hello. Boat raid, everyone. Boat raid. We're talking about the game I am making. I have yet to come up with a full title. I want it to be Gemlington and then something else. Like the name of the area, or I don't know. The first crust. The first crumb. No, I think the final game in the series should be the last crumb. Welcome in, Sea Doggos. Thank you, Isa, for raiding. Killamine. Wait, no. Killamine was already there. William. Lupelmis. Hi all. Patrick. Holy Long Wang. Oh my god, Holy Long Wang. Were you here for the Holy Long Wang cake? Why does Tegu sound so not thrilled? Who's Binding of Isaac? A mole to the past. Hi Tabby Tutu. Live Yuri. Hi Isa Tutu. We're talking about games today. My game specifically, my awesome, amazing farming sim that's going to make a bajillion dollars and, you know, outdo Stardew Valley. just kidding, don't come for me. Do you guys like farming sims? Eat all those? Isa won her first run this game. I don't know what that means, but that's impressive. Farming on golems, interesting. Yes, like Dungeon Messy. I saw her doing, guys. Out of context. Chat messages. Gotta screenshot this one. Screenshotted. The Zelda one inspired Dungeon Crawler. Ooh! Zelda mentioned. I'm taking it easy. Just kidding, Tegu. You know, it's very hard to read tone to text. not trying to start anything. I like watching people play them, but not so much playing them. That's interesting. I also have not been playing games for a long time. Instead, I watch playthroughs. Do you guys know Over the Moon? I remember watching the playthrough for that and I felt quite inspired. Okay, next point is that there will be a set amount of levels and increasing in difficulty. And I don't know if you guys remember this part in... There's a part in Pokemon. I think it was Gold and Silver, where you have to glide on ice. In order to get to where you want to be. So if you just walk around randomly, it's not gonna work. Like if you go the wrong way, you're just gonna slide to you're just gonna slide out without reaching here. So you have to figure out where to go. So for this level, it would be, it's pretty easy. Pretty easy, but no, just to get the idea across. Six. Court. Oh my god. Please just let me drag this little human. Please let me drag you. Struggle. There we go. Finally. Finally. So you break the stone, you come here. And then you slide to this spot. You slide to here, you slide to here, and then go down. And then you reach this spot. This is where you can break the stone and then free the golem. I don't know where it's gonna go. Like, does it follow you afterwards? Maybe. And then you can proceed to try and get to the next level or go back to your dungeon farm. I think it'll be a nice, chill, slightly challenging thing in game that'll get your brain cells working a little bit. I was thinking there could be an interface for farming on the golem's back, but it's, now that I think about it, it's not really necessary. You could just have the player stand next to the golem with a bag of seeds. And a watering can and just friggin' spray it. And just, you don't need to go to an interface really. I think that's more intuitive. Puzzle is nice, yeah. Yeah, I feel like a game, you have to balance how cozy it is. If it's too easy. Because cozy games, you don't want it to be too challenging. But if it's too easy, then you're gonna lose interest. So there has to be a little bit of something to get you to focus once in a while. And I'm trying to achieve that without combat. Is there anything else to say? We'll decide what kind of props we can plant on these. You guys feel free to give me ideas in the game dev channel. Okay, this is just a drawing of basically the game I played earlier, where you can decorate and unlock a bunch of different toppings to decorate with. I think people love this shit. I have not seen a game that's successfully done this, but there is one game called Sticky Business that has a similar mechanic going on, but it is a game where you run a sticker shop, which is just mind-blowing to me, because that was literally my life, running a sticker shop. And to think that someone gamified it, that's insane. You guys should go look it up, but basically you get a bunch of graphic design elements, and then you can collage them together to make your final design. This plus this equals, I don't know, cat planet. And then you fold and put it in a box and ship it. It's crazy. It's crazy. Someone gamified my life. Oh my god. But I get it because running a sticker business is really fun until you have to do like the paperwork stuff. You have to, you know, figure out shipping. Yeah, basically figure out shipping, figure out taxes. Instantly it's not fun anymore. So I kind of get the appeal of the game because you can enjoy the good parts only. Kind of like farming. Real farming is hard. Manual labor. That game sounds amazing. Cooking Mama? What about Cooking Mama? Can we ride golems? Ooh, that'll be a fun feature to add. Yeah, I think this game is supposed to come out soon. Oh, I wonder if we have funds in the mole bank, then we can try it. We can play it together. See if it actually stands up on its own. And another idea is you can customize a fruit sandal. Basically a flat canvas in the middle. And you're free to decorate. People probably make a lot of sussy things. But that's part of the fun. I think a lot of cozy farming sim games have done trains as the main transport, mode of transport. And I feel like we've had enough, as much as I love trains. I think it was in The Witch, the little witch pixel game. I don't remember the name of it. It was like this. The opening scene is in a train, and then restaurant, RPG, sink. Start on a train, I think. So for us, let's do hot air balloons, and maybe during the game, throughout the game, you just see hot air balloons float by as you're farming. That'll be super fun. Is Kumi an I4? Is it I4? Or is it E4? I4. Don't worry about being late. I'm just glad you're here. Thank you for being here. I'm glad you're here at all. Kumi, we're doing good today. I have so many things, so many excited things I'm excited about to share with you guys. I also started following a tutorial. I forgot. I like that. I4, got it. I like trains. I love trains. Don't get me wrong, I love trains, but it's been done a lot. And you know, we're not like other games. I want to show you guys what I managed to make, quote unquote, make on Godot. You guys want to see? Let me open it. Put on my programmer hat. Not really. Put on my tutorial hat. Godot. No, not from the web. I just want to open Godot. Everything is 10 times more difficult. during stream. Hold on a moment. So there's this terrifying phenomenon that I'm dreading called tutorial hell, where you can build things by following tutorials, but you're not able to apply your knowledge to your own unique problems. Like, you cannot come up with your own solution to your own thing are you trying to make. And I don't know how to break out of that. So if you guys know, let me know in game dev channel. Okay, let's put 4 dot. Why is it like? Is this what Godot looks like? It's all neatly packed into one window, which is what I like. I prefer this over floating... What do you call this? Floating widgets? Kind of like how Clip Studio Paint is. I don't know if it's still like that, but that really confused my brain when everything was like the brushes window and the navigator, they were just floating in space. I could never get used to that. Here is something. This beautiful platformer game I have made. How do you close this? And it kind of works. It's obviously it's not a full-fledged game. I learned how to import the tiles, make the character jump but not fall through the tile. I will put up the test screen, the test window. You guys see that? Now you guys see that. Oh, Jesus. That laptop is not having a good day. How do I move? Oh yes, and it's animated, as you can see. Did I move it? No, wrong one. Wow. I just want to move this one. Nope. Lock this. This is locked? Oh, it's locked. Okay. There we go. Great, great success. Let's stick around. I can jump. And you know, you see how when I run, it gradually slows down. By the way, this is not my art, obviously. It's a free package, pixel art package for you to test this kind of stuff, and you can collect the cherries. Oh god. Break a leg. Yeet. It would be fun for us when I've completed the tutorial, maybe we can design a stage together. I also want to learn how to make him jump through the ropes. Like, you know, jump through it, but also can land on it. It's kind kind of really finicky to control. I made a kusage. Okay, I'm going to attempt to collect all of them. I can do it. I made this. No! Shit. This is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. Come on. Now code it again without the tutorial. Exactly. I can't. You know, during the tutorial, sometimes he'll pause and be like, now try to do this step on your own. I'm just like, what? Yay, we did it! We won! So yeah, once I'm done with this series, I'm going to start the Farming Sim tutorial series. And I'm going to use my own sprites. Tabby, not pro at games. What do you mean? We won! We can have a look at the coding, the code. So, I don't even know enough to say anything, but yeah, indents are important, guys. If you don't indent, it doesn't work. They didn't explain why. That's my problem with tutorials. They show you, but they don't explain the reason behind it. That's why tutorial hell is a thing, because how can I apply it if I don't understand it? It's not like art where you copy something and then you start to understand it. Or is it? Some things you just have to, you know, get a proper lesson on. You need to nest them. I don't know what that means. But yeah, for one of the parts I was missing an indent, and it took me hours to figure out. Like, I was struggling for at least half an hour. And I had to walk away from it and then come back to read the YouTube comments to find out what was wrong. And I think I like this because it reminds me of Life 2D, actually. Actually up here. Parent-child relationship. This system reminds me of Life 2D. So at least it's somewhat familiar. And I like the way you can import tiles. It's quite intuitive. Tile map. Like this, you just drop it into file system and then you drag it up here somewhere. I don't like how it's up here. It should have just been down here. Maybe you can. No, I think you can. But for the area 2D items, you have to drag it up here. You have to put it up here. I don't know where. That's the problem. You know. Could have been more intuitive. Texture. Material. I don't remember. Not Python, but very, very close. It was our Python. Yeah. I have seen some Python, like, some people not Python fans. I guess the Godot segment's over. Let me know if you have questions. I have closed it. What do now? What are we doing now? Yes. Hot air balloons is going to where it's to be where your character will be in the beginning, and you'll be able to move around. But one problem is I feel like I want a bigger area for the character to run around and explore upon entering the game. This is a bit restricting. Maybe we can have... I can design a station away from the town, and then that can be where you start. Also, does anyone have ideas on how we can introduce character customization? Like, something that works with the storyline. Maybe the character will be in their room? That's kind of a boring introduction. But then if the player is already on the hot air balloon, it'll be weird for the player to look different in the beginning. And then you go into character customization and then it becomes you. So maybe I would have to make this an actual carriage. Like an actual carriage with a bathroom. This is what a restaurant RPG did. Inside the carriage, there's a bathroom. And then in there, your character transforms. There's a mirror. Yeah, maybe it won't just be a basket. And then there'll be other travelers you can talk to. Loop inside loop. The loop inside is nested. I see. Let's see. What did I miss? You can do tavern sprite submissions. That'll be fun. Yeah, maybe I can let you guys customize a sprite and then maybe winners or like random winners get to be in the game. Or like all of you. So we will have Tabby Tavern. Maybe every day there'll be a random selection of moles. A random set of moles, and then you guys can be one of them. But I would have to come up with dialogue. Maybe that can be part of your submission. Maybe one day is this guy chatting with, I don't know, Panda Kenneth. You guys having a beer. Ooh, also brewing. Should we have brewing in the Tabby Tavern? Just a very simple thing. The simple, you put it into the machine and then it comes out. You put wheat into a machine and then it comes out as beer. I don't know what the beer brewing system looks like. I don't know. That would be really fun. You could select puzzles submitted by us. Ooh! Level designs by moles. That's a great idea. And then we can have infinite levels. But then there's a limit to how many columns you can keep. Maybe you can collect them all. Like you can put them in storage if you're not using them. I don't know how that makes sense. You would have to set a bunch of rules, limitations, and models. But it would be fun and a good way of participation. You know, my question is, this kind of submission participation, I would probably have to have a disclaimer saying, like, this is volunteer participation, you know? Because technically it is work for you guys, and I am taking it for free. So I would have to have a disclaimer and maybe some sort of form you guys need to sign to be like, Tabby can use this freely. Right? I need a lawyer up. I need to nest them. Okay. That's easy. I learned that in high school. Lucky. I don't think I never learned it in high school. Indenting is there for the program to know what part of the code is part of what section. I see. Kind of like a Word document. Probably assumed you knew about programming beforehand. I did not. Language treats it like a what? Chat jumped away. Gnome call. yeah, gnome call. Migrate to a real engine. Wait. Is this not a real engine? This is a lot of different opinions, and how do I know which one to follow? Can we get Tabby breakdancing? Why? But why? Maybe. Is that going to be a Kickstarter goal? Kickstarter goal. Tabby breakdancing. And then Tabby parkours. I'm just going to be the clown of the game, aren't I? Okay, we're planning our Kickstarter right now. Our goals. And then Tabby parkours. What's next? What else can you make the sad clown do? Hello, Seek. Welcome in. Tabby LLC. Brewing, I'm in. I would love to learn more about brewing. Careful not to bite off more than you can chew. I already have. But yes, I'm going to... So the plan is... regarding where to start. The question, the big question of where to start. I watched a talk by Concerned Ape. Concerned Ape had a talk somewhere. At university, maybe? He said he made a shitty version of the game in about 2 to 3 months. And then he just continued to refine and build on that base. So I think that's the approach I'm going to take when I actually start. And that's when I'm actually ready to start. Before that, I think I will make a bunch of related mini games, such as turning this into a minigame. Plus the cake one. Basically make a bunch of mini games and then they all come together in the end. Does that sound like a reasonable plan? Then it's more digestible for me. You know, when you make parts separately, can you just drag and drop it into your into a different game pile and then compile them? I don't know. Unpaid labor, here we go. Do it for members. That's a great idea. No VIP moles would want to harm you. That's a, you know, this always the 0.02%, just like bacteria. It's never 100%. Trim the other systems, leave the brewing. Why? Okay, Red. Spoken like a true alcoholic. Like the magic mixing pots in Dragon Quest. I don't know what that is. But maybe. What was your main learning source when doing game dev stuff? You mean the 1 week I did game dev stuff? I just looked up YouTube. I just looked on YouTube. And I did the first Godot tutorial that popped up. That's basically it. Tabby juggle. Third goal. Tabby juggles. You know, I'm only week two into it, so if I do dumb stuff, it's normal. But yeah, doing maybe a special tier for VIP moles to have their own avatar be part of the game would be really fun. Juggle. Sounds like a good approach for someone with no experience. Cool, cool, cool. Good to know. This is looking super cool, cute. Thank you, Tenchi. I really hope I can make this happen for you guys to play. Honestly, I just want you guys to be able to play. Maker says no need for signed form, just a brief terms and conditions page that any submissions are voluntary and can be used for the purposes you intend. Oh, as simple as that, huh? That's doable. Thank you. Solid strat. So yeah, maybe you guys will be able to make buff bread soon. Like, when I have one part finished, I will release it somewhere so you guys can play a little demo. How's that sound? Oh, I'm so dehydrated. Drink break. I will show you guys all the sprites without the background. This is easier to see. Besides the cow. Except the cow. We're losing her. Is inspired by my cat. The shape language. Oh, good time to talk about choosing a resolution and what size to draw your sprite in and what size to draw buildings and items. The bread looks funky. Please ignore the dots. So for resolution, you just take the most common screen resolution and I don't remember what it is. 1920 by something. What is it? Mm, 1920 by something. You guys must know. Yeah. Basically, you need to make sure it's scaled. correctly, 1920 by something. So you just take this size and you can do half of it or a quarter of it. I think that means it will scale correctly. Right? Yeah, 1080, that's the one. And my current canvas size is 640 by 360. And you can go less, which is 320 times. What's the half of 36, guys? Shit. Help. Wait. 16? $180, thank you. I did not get very good grades in maths, as you can tell. That's really embarrassing. Yeah, so you can go with this. Probably not this for pixel game. I think I want pretty detailed background, so I'm going to aim for this. Even though for beginners, smaller is better. Beginner friendly. Well, I feel like for sprites, the smaller you go is actually more difficult. Because every pixel matters if it's so small. Right. So my sprite is about this size. I think the point is you have to make sure it divides by two. Don't remember why, but that's what I remember. And sprites can be 16 by 16 is also a common size for sprites. Me spreading misinformation. Disclaimer, I am a total noob. Please don't treat this as informational video. I'm just sharing my experience. It's another common size. Probably it will go well with the lower resolution, I imagine. And what about everything else? Like the buildings, the items? Well, Mr. Adams says, once you have the sprite dimensions decided, then you just draw everything to scale to your character. Like, you just make it make sense with your character. And that's the basis of it. Let me know if this is not true or you have a better tip. Yeah, 16 by 9. Thanks for the mathematics help. Oh my god, Meeks. Oh, Meeks. Oh, I love it already. Love what? I hope you mean my game. This is gonna be the best game forever. Best game ever. Make a goal, merch about the game. Yes! This is another thing I feel like Stardew is not like hitting the nail on the head. Stardew is not very much. What do you call it? It's not very IP friendly. Like, not very easy to make merch of. Maybe because the style of the characters, they're not, it's not a very popular style. I have seen a lot of amazing fan art though, but the official art is, like, I don't think I have seen much Stardew merch at all. Let me know if you have seen cool Stardew merch, I would love to see. But yes, my game will be super duper merchable because everything's going to be super round and we're gonna have so many cats. And oh my god, don't get me started on the food art. We're going to have so much food art. Like drawings of cute breads. Can't wait. It's gonna take tons of work. The sea moles look so cute. Thank you, thank you. Agreed, it's super hard to get defined characters super small. Think 640 is the resolution for vampire survivors. Yeah, it'll be helpful to give some examples of from each solution. I mean, resolution. So here is an example. Yeah, I would say this is quite detailed. This is what we're working with. You can do shading. This game looks fun. Are these gems you can collect? Oh, I would love to collect these. So satisfying, the, you know, grabbing the coins. And what's the lower resolution example? Those refer to the height and pixels for this 16 to 9 ratio. Got it. What about Omori? What resolution is Omori? Omori resolution. I feel like I looked this up before and people were talking about the game scaling instead of what resolution it was designed in. Show you guys and you tell me what it looks like. I feel like it looks like 640. It doesn't even look like pixel art. Maybe we should look at this instead. Instead of the fighting screen. Oh, actually this looks a little more. Wait, but there's shading going on. I feel like this is 640. Diamond hoe doesn't get crafted unless someone's playing a prank. What are we talking about? I don't play Minecraft. Celeste is 320 by 180. Celeste. Wait, this also looks really detailed. Maybe it's just skill issue. Okay, you can tell the difference. Yeah, the pixels are more apparent. compared to here, the lines less jaggedy. But this is beautifully done. Maybe in some ways, less pixel is more challenging. Because you have to really be able to manipulate the pixels well for it to not read as super jaggedy. And I don't know if pixel artists do this. This is a question. Do pixel artists sketch like normally? Like non-pixel, do a non-pixel sketch and then scale it down to create pixel art. Is this a method? Or is this like sacrilegious? I have seen somebody make a sketch and then import it into the pixel canvas and then draw over it in pixel. In pixel. Less pixels is harder. Gotcha. Got to get all of the strawberries. I didn't know there were strawberries in Celeste. How much is Undertale? This has become a guessing game. Guess the resolution. Let's see. Maybe same as Celeste. Yeah, same as Celeste. That's what I guess. You see, is down here more boxy? The trees look so good though. Even with less pixels. Really impressive. I have seen it done both ways. Ooh, there's sketch workflows. Do you remember the name of the artist? If it also helps, GBA games are 240 by 180. SNES games are so many numbers to read. So on. Thank you, that's very helpful to know. And I did... I think Adam in his video also used these as examples. I think for modern day pixel art games, they're usually a bit larger, depending on the game. Like for what we're trying to do, probably a bit larger. I feel like we got through pretty much everything. Is there anything you guys want to work on together for the rest of the stream? Oh, here's the... I'm not happy with this, but this is the me trying to figure out how to plan the map. I think this is more challenging. This is super challenging. I'm not very good with sense of space. I don't know how to arrange things for it to feel nice. So this is going to be a challenge that I'm excited to conquer. I don't know if I want a river on the farm, but I think it would be really nice to have a mill. Like, have a mill attached to maybe the chicken coop, because it's grinding up the fodder. And it'll add a constant movement to the scene. That would be really nice to look at, I feel like. But yeah, I have to work on this a bit more. I'm not happy with this positioning arrangement. And I was thinking, for customization, maybe I can leave the sides of the house empty. Or like at least one corner of it empty for you to decorate, really. That would be nice. And on the other side, maybe we'll have some foliage. Have some foliage to really show the seasons. So in the morning when you in the morning when you leave the house, first thing you see is the trees changing color, and then there's like some movement, some birds, or like snow. Maybe a pond to show fish and stuff, and you can fish in it. I think changing of seasons is something I want to really showcase around the house. Because imagine you wake up in the morning on the first day of autumn, and then you see the big tree next to your house has changed colors. I think that's good communication. Visual communication. And of course, in the morning you see all the fruits of your labor. Very rewarding. Question for you guys is that, do game devs plan the map in the program, in the engine? Or do they draw the map entirely on a pixel art? On a pixel art program, and then import the whole map into the engine? Or do they piece it together tile by tile on the engine? Maybe it's a mix. I feel like maybe when there's more organic, like stuff not following the grid kind of stuff happening, then it's drawn with a pixel art program and then the whole thing's imported. That's where my logic leads me. They used graph paper in the old days. Oh my god. Yes, let me just bring out my dusty graph paper. Definitely have some on hand. NPCs, maybe that's another way you guys can participate. But yes, let's leave NPCs for another stream. Like we can cook up some waifus together. I will come up with the character setting and then we can brainstorm what they're gonna look like. Emmy Chang is the artist for Undertale. Ooh. Asian? Is she Asian? Yeah, Tammy, cool. Tabby needs to play more games. I do. I want to try out all the farming sims that come out. Let's do it. Like a first impressions game. There's one called Mystria. Fields of Mystria, I'm interested in. When that comes out, I hope we can play it together. This is giving Sailor Moon. The character's art style is basically Sailor Moon. I think they do both. Yeah, that makes sense. I think for like platformer or dungeon level designing, you do it tile by tile in the engine. And for more organic environments, it's the other way around. Watch a tutorial. I will. This stream is helping me work so hard right now. How? Tile setting is like painting pixel art on Godot anyway. But per tile. Yes. It kind of reminds me of Animal Crossing. When you lay down the custom designs. There are specialized tile map tools out there. Not sure how they work with the in-engine tile editor. Oh, like plugins. That's good to know. How are you here? Aren't you supposed to lurk? He can't help himself. He can't help himself. He has to tell us how much work he's, how productive he's being because of us. Ooh, Lilith is excited for this too. It does have a 90s shoujo style, doesn't it? Mommy. The magician cell, the guy is cute. Ooh, is it the redhead? The kind of pissed off looking one that looks like... What's his face? The Frieren character? He looks like... I forgot his name. The Frieren character. Frieren... guy. Frieren, red hair boy. Stock. He looks like Stock. Yeah, I love this design. Should I show you all of the characters? I feel like the big interest point. Celine, the good girl, the vanilla. I'm sorry. Slander. Here we have vanilla ice cream and ube ice cream, and then, you know. Really fantastic designs. I'm going to save this as my reference. Who do you guys like? Who would you romance? There's more. Ooh. This is Howl. You cannot tell me this is not Howl. He looks like Stock but better. Oh my god. Poor Stock. The red head. Wait, Kumi, what do you mean? Kumi's neurons activated. He reminds me of Nami from HM. What is HM? Nami HM. Harvest Moon? Yeah, kind of. I see it. The eyes. Okay. Oh, he's called March. Interesting. Yeah, they kind of have similar vibes. I feel like March is more, what do you call it? Hot-blooded. Yes. This is more of a aloof character. Who would I romance? I think for guys, probably these two. I'm interested in this guy's story. not this one. Maybe, I don't think, no. Maybe, I think... the design is not piquing my interest. I do like her though. She looks really sweet. I think out of the girls, she is most interesting. Reina is most interesting. I'm not interested in vanilla ice cream. What? I feel like for her, they would have to really beef up her story. Reina is also pretty. She's so pretty. Like, that color of lipstick. She ate that. I don't see Migu on this list. Oh no. Oh no. Wait, who looks like Migu? None of them really. Damn it. I could have changed the name. Oh yeah, I'm really, really curious about the mystery love interest. That's really interesting. Why are they special? Is it like the harvest goddess? Like a hidden love interest you can raise up? But the Harvest Goddess has really bad story, like no story. Oh, I can't stop looking at these. I love it. Oh, this is a lady. Actually, maybe sign me up. This is my harem. Oldest one looks like Migu. Oldest one. Migu's not even that old. The hair's completely different. Reina is making. What does that mean? I like Adeline. Adeline design. The pink is cute. Oh, the acids. Wait, but they all have acids. Actually, the mummy has least acids. I think. That's unexpected. Plot twist. What else is there to look at? Oh, I'll show you guys Sticky Business. The sticker shop game. Oh my god, it kind of looks like it's giving me trauma. It's bringing back my trauma. Kind of looks like the Cricut online editor. I used the silhouette, but I still recognize this kind of interface. Here's Sticky Business. It is pixel art. Cool. I wanna show you guys the design page, the customization page, and because I'm gonna be referencing it. So like this, kind of like Microsoft Paint or something. And you have assets over here. Categories, transform tools. Imagine if you can do this with cake and bread decoration. So fun. If they can do it, maybe I can do it. At least I can see that it's been done before. A similar concept, so I know it's possible. And I want to show you guys what it looks like when you ship off the stickers. It's literally bringing me back to all the sticker shop vlogs I used to consume on daily. It's actually fun until things get too complicated. I would recommend anyone like kids, or not kids, but younger people to start a sticker business just to get some life experience. Or some sort of art business, or whatever you're into. Felting, crochet, try it. I really wish when I was younger I did my own thing sooner instead of wallowing. Work is a bit easier now, but everything is still new here. Do you think you can add more stickers with cute text on them? That would be awesome. Oh! So you get customer requests. That makes things interesting. Short break so I can chat a little. Super interesting stream so far from what I've heard. Game devving is hard. It's like climbing Mount Everest, except when you get to the top, you find a ladder to space, and you have to climb that too. Me and you on the same page, Tabby. Oh, really? We're gonna be rivals, Wally. Oh, Tenchi, same. Super curious about the stories when it comes out. Yeah, I really hope the stories are just as good as the character designs. Otherwise, what a letdown. Adeline is such a cute name. I love it too. You guys can help me name characters. That would be a fun thing to do. Because Tabby would look at the assets first. I mean, this is the world we live in. Assets are important. Gallo looks like he will take you to a local D&D club. Who the hell's Gallo? Gallo or Bala? Wait, is this a G? This is Bala. No, he looks like he's going to... he's going to set his heart on fire, become Blackbird. That's what he looks like he's about to do. Cozy. Why is this so millennial? Is this gonna be the millennial game? Will you be posting the name of that one game we were just looking at? Not Sticky Business. Wait, which game? What does it, like, what's the game about? I don't remember what game. Morning, Fog-san. I've set your work on fire. Why? From sticker vlogs to slime shorts. Oh my god, slime shorts are so good. You know, slime shorts, it's the reason I realized that sound design is more important than I thought it was. Because imagine if you're mixing the ingredients, you get that ASMR sound. Oh, I think that would take it to the next level. Hopefully it's not too difficult to do, just a matter of recording and editing, chopping up the sounds correctly. I don't know enough about sound. Badge pins. Don't forget badges. Oh god. I never made badges for my shop. I probably should have. A very good starter merch. What was this? Am I saying that correctly? What? Hauling a stone? Pushing a stone? Up a hill? This is giving... It's giving... getting over it. Yeah, Fields of Mystery. Wait, but I showed it. Will you be posting the name? Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the one, sorry. I'm dumb. Okay, I think I have talked about everything I wanted to talk about. What should we do for ending doodle? Any requests? Should I do an Isa doodle? Because raid Isa doodle. Isa. You guys can ask for other stuff too. I'm just gonna doodle Isa as you. Come up with something. What should I draw Isa doing? Isa. Oh my god. Oh. What if? What if? Okay. Fishing mechanism. Gemlington game fishing mechanism. I want to possible Easter egg. game Easter egg. You get to board the Easter boat. Wait, this is not right. This is hard to read. Oh yeah, I think Shiro, you said Shiro during our collab. Yeah, what did you guys think of the collab, by the way? I had so much fun. When Shiro said he wanted to practice doodling, that made me realize how goated being able to doodle is for content creation. Because if I didn't know how to doodle, I probably would have Like, making thumbnails would have been super difficult. Especially in the beginning. Let's say I'm the player. Ooh, what if as a Kickstarter perk, you get to play as Tabby? Like, you get a mod where you can play as Tabby, and then you get different dialogue. And then we're gonna have Mayray. Oh my god, what if when you catch a manta ray in the game, it just says, "Yippee!" I don't know how to make a literal boat look like Isa. This is gonna be in the game, guys. Yippee! What's Isa's saying? What's Isa's tagline? Oh boy! Oh! That's it. I did my research. Accepted. What? It collab with two or more at once. I feel like that would be very overwhelming for me as a botty. Hello, Killia. Welcome in. Big butt. Thank you for your input. Push the stone to the top of the mountain so it can fall back down and repeat the process as a punishment. Yes, that's exactly how it's gonna play out. Okay, this is another ending doodle. Ending doodle number two. First, I'm gonna be like, I can do this. And then it's gonna... Why do you need a stone at the top of the hill anyway? Maybe the whole project was... Maybe the whole project... It was cursed from the beginning. There was no point in the beginning. How do you say that, Sisyphus? At least I'll be at the top of the hill. And this symbolizes, even though the project's gone to shit, at least I have learned. I have a skill set now, and I can rebuild. Like, I have muscles now. And I can push easier and faster next time. Try. Mini Tabby fishing. Yeah, I can make a bunch of mini games. Wonder if it will be available on Steam. We're getting ahead of ourselves here. I hope. But what did you miss? Oh, the name? No worries. It was so fun, Tabby, the interviewer. Yes, I love to ask questions. And I didn't tell Shiro beforehand. So, jump scared him. It was a great collab. You both did lovely. Thank you. Really liked it. Thank you. For a second, I was imagining, like, interviewing Goose But then I got very scared. I instantly became afraid. Migu likes to say I come with my own boss BGM, but for me it's Goose. Goose, when I see Goose, it's just big boss. Like big boss fight music playing. Twerking easy, GG. Wow, so insightful, Delia. Doodle plus storytelling equals infinite content. So true. Practice doodling. I actually took a lot of inspiration from Ina and Yuna. Yuna Yu. For my doodle style. You guys want a place to start? You all know Ina. She's blowing up these days. One must imagine Tabby Sisyphus. Am I saying it right? It's meaningless. It's a form of infinite torture. It's not meaningless if you gain these guns. Nothing is ever a waste of time. That's what I like to say. You're saying it right. Cool. Katamari. Oh my god, I loved Katamari. I never figured out how to play it properly, but it was so satisfying. Ooh, what if like the bread? This doesn't make sense actually. And then there's like the ingredients. And then you have to roll. Roll up the ingredients. Okay, that's a dumb idea. I'm just trying to put all the games I like into one game. And I'm gonna make myself suffer for it. First segment in the game where it's a show made by moles. By moles where they dance or do theater. I was thinking that relates to an idea I had. I was thinking, like, you know how children, they'll play pretend and like put on a show. I think that would be a cute scene. But like a friendship cutscene with some kids. Yeah, so yeah, cute idea. I thought you meant ENA, the indie series game. What's that? You roll up a giant dough of bread. You'll also get strong legs. Exactly. If you find purpose on your rock pushing, then it's not meaningless. If you push, an ever-increasing ball of junk is way more meaningful. If you push an ever-increasing ball of junk is way more meaningful? Why is junk more meaningful? Because it makes you strong. And because you find purpose in it. And you add more ingredients for the big dill bun, which will then go in the massive oven. Yes, massive oven. Okay, I could go on forever talking about game. Like what I want to do for the game. I need to end. But thank you so much for listening to me yap away about this near impossible project. But no, we can do it. Thank you for watching, and we'll continue the discussion in the Tabby Tavern, so make sure you join us, join the party. Thank you for watching. Make sure to eat well, sleep well. I'll see you again tomorrow or something. Tabby out! Oh, remember to smash that motherfucking like and subscribe. Okay, so we're going to raid. I'm back! Can't get rid of me! Alright, alright. No, no inserting ads, YouTube. We don't do that here. I'm so good to you guys. Oh shit, I can also raid Mei, but she's like overtaken me. Maybe we can help out. Levy. What's the username? Mei Ray is live. Okay, I'm having him start it up. Boo, I'm back. since Fali suggested Levy first, and because Mei Ray has already surpassed me, big sad. we can raid him instead. Fair enough. You guys agree? Well, let me know when the room is up. Because it won't show up otherwise. Currently it says no matching results. Bolts burrow. Fake author. Epic fail, thanks. Mei Ray's wrapping up too. Okay. Tricked you guys. I will, as a special, I will draw fan art of the beautiful PP cake I created earlier. Wait, when I look on my stream, why is the screen kind of flashing? Is it flashing for you guys? I hope not. I never watch my own streams. I don't know if there's like problems with my streams. Hope it looks normal for you guys, because sometimes the YouTube streaming preview is weird. Oh, that means I have to draw it. Oh no, it looks. Oh no, I can't do that. I am wearing pants. It's kind of hard to read. There we go. There's some strawberries. EP cake. Good night, Tegu. Thank you for watching. Screen looks good. Cool. Had a heart attack for a second. Stream contracted ligma. Okay. Okay. You all have ligma now. So, sorry to break it to you guys. Are you making a farming sim? Yes, Quackster! Are you new here, Quackster? If so, then oh my god, lucky, because we were going to stop stream, but then now we're waiting to raid someone. If I had ended stream, you never would have discovered us. Never would have unearthed us. We're living under a rock. Hanging out under our little rock. We have been found. Do you like farming sims? Yeah, first time. Really nice to meet you, Quackster. Glad you were able to chat with us for like 2 minutes. But yes, I'm making a farming sim and I'm going to share my journey with you guys in the form of game dev streams. So yeah, make sure to smash that motherfucking like and subscribe if you're interested in game dev content. Cool. Oh my god, it's showing up. Great. And yeah, see you guys. Was it out for real this time? Also, watch the VOD if you wanna see what the game's gonna be like.